Hi everyone, my name is Amrish. You are watching Gourmet at Home. Today I will be preparing a dish from the southern part of India, and it is not specific to any one particular region. If it is in Kerala, they call it roast. In Tamil Nadu, they call it varuval. In Andhra, they call it vepadu. But by chance, if this dish is in northern part of India, for them it will be a bhuna. The recipe that I will be cooking today is curry leaf chicken or curry patta murg or curry vepallai koi varuval or curry vepaku kodi vepadu. Curry leaves are used as one of the main flavoring agent in most of the South Indian curries. But in this recipe, curry leaves are used as the main ingredient to impart flavors, aroma, texture and the color. When I tried this dish for the first time, my perception about the curry leaves has completely changed. I'm sure after watching today's video, you will try this recipe in your kitchen and you will start loving your curry leaves. So let's start preparing the recipe of curry leaf chicken. For this recipe of curry leaf chicken, I will be using lots of curry leaves. And I have a chicken on the bone curry cut. Along with that, I will be using spices like clove, peppercorn, green cardamom, cinnamon, cumin seeds, and some powdered spices like turmeric and chili powder. So in the first step of the recipe, we will roast the spices along with lots of curry leaves. We'll blend them to a fine paste and then we'll make the masala for the chicken. We will start by adding approximately 2 to 3 tablespoons of oil in the pan. Once the oil is ready, we will add 3 to 4 pieces of cloves, small piece of cinnamon stick and 3 pieces of green cardamom. Along with that, I will add 1.5 teaspoon of fennel seeds, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, let's take 1.5 teaspoons of cumin seeds, followed by I will add 2 teaspoons of black peppercorn, 2 teaspoons, and then I will add the curry leaf to the spices. We'll gently saute our spices along with the curry leaves. So we can see the spices are roasted and the curry leaves are fried. They are crispy in texture. At this stage, we'll put off the flame and we'll transfer the curry leaf and the spice mixture in the blending jar. After adding the sauteed curry leaf and spices, I will add some cold water to the blending jar. After making the fine puree of curry leaves and the spices, let's start with the second step of the recipe, where we will make the masala for the chicken with some chopped onion, ginger, garlic, coconut and some tamarind. So let's start first by adding some oil to the pan. I will add approximately 3 tablespoons of oil for this recipe. So once the oil is ready, we will add chopped onions. Followed by chopped onions, I will add 2 teaspoons of salt. Adding of salt to the onions at this stage expedites the cooking process because it helps in releasing the water from the onions. Now we can see the onions are soft. At this stage, we'll add chopped garlic, chopped ginger, Now the onions are almost golden brown and we have sauteed the garlic and ginger in this. At this stage, I will add 3 teaspoons of coriander powder, 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder and 1 teaspoon of chili powder. We'll saute our spices with the onions, followed by we will add the coconut paste, now this coconut paste will tend to stick on the bottom of the pan, so if you want you can add little water in between and continue sauteing the masala. Once the coconut paste is nicely roasted with the onions, we will add the tamarind pulp. After adding the tamarind pulp, we saute the masala for another 2 to 3 minutes and then we will add the diced chicken. We will carefully mix the chicken with the masala. After adding the chicken to the masala, we will reduce the flame and will continue cooking the chicken until the chicken starts releasing its moisture. Now the chicken has almost sauteed with the masala and it has started releasing the moisture. At this stage, we will add our curry leaf puree or the paste to the chicken. After adding the curry leaf puree to the chicken masala, we will continue cooking on a slow flame, but we have to make sure that we need to mix the chicken in between. Curry leaves are native to India. They are available round the year. They thrive in tropical and subtropical climatic conditions. Curry leaves, they come with lot of health benefits. They are considered to be good source of vitamin C and calcium, rich in iron and folic acid. Curry leaves, they have got woody and earthy flavor. Sometimes they give the notes of asafoetida, fennel and lime. When you roast or fry the curry leaves, they give a very nice nutty flavor in them. Sometimes we confuse the curry leaves with curry powder. Curry powder is a blend of spices. Curry leaf is a green herb. Keep on mixing the chicken in between and make sure you scrape the sides because there the main flavor lies in the pot. Curry leaf chicken is almost cooking for 20 minutes. The chicken is cooked, the masala is dry, it has got that strong flavor of curry leaves and the spices that we have added, perfectly coating the chicken. So let's finish the curry leaf chicken with some fresh coriander leaves. After adding the coriander leaves, let's start plating the curry leaf chicken. So I have lined the serving bowl with banana leaf just to make it look more classical, more traditional. Here I've got the pickled onions, some crispy fried curry leaves and some grated coconut. I want to serve this curry leaf chicken as a meal in a platter. So here I have got a 3 compartment tray. I will be serving the curry leaf chicken in the center and on the sides the crispy papadam and the paratha. Hope you like this version of curry leaf chicken. Curry leaf is mainly used as a flavoring herb, but in this recipe we have used curry leaf as the main ingredient. It's all about knowing your ingredient and using it to its best potential. I am sure you will try this recipe in your kitchen. Looking forward to see you again in our next episode of Gourmet at Home.